Hello, my name's Anthony Hall, and in this tutorial we're going to be modelling a basic hammer. So the first thing I did is I just went on Google, searched hammer images, just had a look at a few similar to this, just for reference images and stuff, and then decided how I was going to go about modelling it. So let's start using the box tool, and in the side view let's draw out something that I can use for the handle. So something like this. And what I'll do is I'll bring up the numerical. So you can N on your keyboard, or at the bottom you can click on numerical. Let's give it some segments through the Y. Let's say 16, and then we'll give it 2 on the X and Z. Okay, something like that. So I'm going to use this to get some kind of profile of the handle. And like I said, I've just been looking on the Google. So I'm going to go to modify and drag, and I'm going to drag the actual corners in the top view. So when it's doing them all the way down. And we'll make some kind of oval shape, like so. So the reason I'm doing this is that when I press tab on the keyboard to subpatch it, you can get this kind of shape. Okay, so I'm okay with that. Next, what I'll do is I'll just maybe give it, because a lot of hammers have this kind of lip at the bottom, look. They always have a lot of them have these little lips, so I'll just manipulate the bottom a little bit. So what I'm doing is zooming in the side view, and then I'm holding Alt down on my keyboard, and the actual icon changes look, so you can drag the viewport. And then while I'm on drag still, let's just drag these points out and roughly make some kind of profile of the lip, and then we can press tab key and you can have a look. In fact, what you can do, if you want, if you go to points, you can select these points and you can just literally use the move tool and look in the perspective view, decide on how you want them to go. And again, or you can just jump to the drag and decide. I think that'll do. I don't really need to. You get the gist of it. You can decide yourself how much of a lip you want. So what I'm going to do now, I've got the basic shape. Let's just untab it. Now, while on the edge tool, I'm going to miss the first few rows out of edges and select these two edges here. Look at this. Like you can see, I've missed three. And then I'm going to select an edge, two edges, every other row. Oops, not that one. Like so, look. And then I'm going to go select loop. While you've got this on, I'm going to go to the multiply, and if you can't see it, under more, edge bevel, and this will give you the option to create a new row of polys, and I just want a thin row like that, look. So we'll say that, drop the selection. Then I'm going to switch to the polygon option, and I'm going to select the two polys that's at the front, like I did, that I've just made, so I can loop them all the way around, like so, and then loop, so you've got this. Then we're going to go to multi-shift, bring up the numerical, make sure group polys on. Now when you first open it, under the shift option here, it'll say contour, switch it to local points normal. So what this will do, it will let us bring the polys in and out slightly. Now having a look, it's up to you how far you want this to actually come in. I'm just gonna say that much, so it's up to you. So what I'm doing is I'm actually bringing the polys in Let's bring it, so up and down, I'll bring it tighter. Up and down, side to side. Let's say that. So what I've done is sucked it in and made sure the actual cap all the way around is the same. Let's drop that selection, and then I'm going to forward slash to drop that selection. Then let's tab it again. And then what you get is this kind of style, like so. Now you can even do a bit more to that. So let's switch to points, and I'm going to select the points, look, of each side, holding shift. So there's two, look, can you see I'm selecting all the way through, like so. Let's move it down. So rather than, like so, so rather than it just going all the way around, let's then, well, I've got this selected, so I've got it selected on both sides. I'm going to use the move tool and control, and I'm just going to pull it down a little bit to about there. So you've got this kind of look now, which is quite nice. Also on some hammers, you've they kind of arch a little bit, so we could arch it. About the simplest way maybe is, while you're on points, let's lasso round, let's say the bottom half. Let's go to under the action centers to mouse, rotate, and let's rotate here, look, so it's rotating where the mouse click is, like so. So just a little bit, deselect it. Let's do the set, and then you could do the same to the top. So let's lasso the top bit, rotate wherever you click, and that's it really. And so what you've got is this kind of arch stylized kind of hammer. So next bit, let's go and make some kind of ridge or top to this. So I'm going to select the two top polys, and let's under multiply, let's go to bandsaw, bring up the numerical. So with the default, that's probably fine, so we'll just leave it, space bar, and we'll drop selection. So you've got this kind of an extra row of polys. We could do it again, so let's select those two at the top now, click the bandsaw again, just drop the selection, so you've kind of got this, like so. Then what you could do is, if you wanted to, is let's just select, let's see if we can loop these around, and the next row. And then if we go back to the multi-shift, bring up numerical, the N on the keyboard, leave the settings the same. Let's have a look in the top view, and let's pull it out slightly, and let's bring it in a little bit. So you're getting this ridge. So what we're going to do is use this bit here, look, these polygons here, to bring the actual metal bit of the handle up, which looks quite nice. So, like I said, with this bit selected, let's press A on the keyboard. We could literally just, let's just bring it up. So I'm maximizing my side view, my left view. Let's use multi-shift, just reset it to make sure the settings are all back where they were. So shift is back to contour, group polys. And if you click and bring up, it will bring up the polys like so. So if you'd rather see what it's going to be looking like in this view. So I've brought it up once, but what I'm going to do once it's gone so far is I'm going to right mouse click, which will flatten it and bring another section up. And then if you let go and right mouse click again, it will keep doing this. So you can decide on how thin or fat these segments are, like so. It's looking more like a samurai sword. So again, bring it up one more time. So you've got this kind of, let's say this is our metal bit, like so. And then what we'll do is we'll shut this down, like so. Then we could probably definitely need to make it a bit thinner. So I'm going to switch to points, deselect them ones, and I'm going to right mouse click and lasso select the actual points that make it up, like so. Then let's go to local, so it stays in position, and it's stretched. And so we can decide now to bring this in. Let's bring it in a bit, And then if you want, you could deselect the bottom few and bring these in thinner. You need to look at some hammers and decide, and then let's bring it in again. In fact, let me just go back. I meant to bring it in all the on both sides. So bring it in and decide how you want that to be. So let's use the move tool. We can then manipulate it, bring it down. It does rotate if you look with the. So if we want to rotate it, we can jump back to the mouse selection and again rotate it, so it's kind of going with the rest. And again, what we need to do now is let's just sort this top bit out, ready to make and connect the top. So we want to set these two polys. Let's bandsaw, just using the default. It's cool. Oops. Deselect the bottom row, and then we're going to just bandsaw that again. Deselect. And then we can actually leave this ready to add our hammer. If you wish, a bit like what we did before, you can select these two polys, loop them, go to multi-shift, numerical, switch the shift to local points again, and then you could bring it out like so, you know, making it a section ready to attach the top part of the hammer. Now at this stage, I'm not sure if this is probably too long. If you think it is too long, you just need to literally come here, look, make sure you're on points down here, select some points, the top points, and then you can actually move the sections down, just being careful, taking your time. Do you know what I mean? So it's like this. If you want, if you think it's too long, I mean, every hammers are different, you've got different lengths for everything. So again, now we're just on to the top bit. So okay, so next let's have a go at making the top. So put the handle in the background, and what I'm gonna do is just simply start with a box. So in the top view, let's draw the box out. If I go to numerical, put in 2x2x2 in your X, Y, and Z, and make it a rough size like this, something like that. Okay, so I drop the selection. Next, let's say this is the front here. I'm gonna space bar through to my points here at the bottom and select this point here. Then what I'm gonna do is go to multiply tab, chamfer, and let's chamfer this point, making a diamond like this, to about that size, like so. So we're going to use this to kind of pull out and make part of the main hammer part. So while we're on here, let's bevel it in slightly. So I'm going to the bevel tool, I'm holding control, and I'm beveling it in a little bit, so you get this kind of ridge. And then I'm gonna hold right mouse click and while holding control and bevel it in again just a little bit, so you've got this, so it gives us a stronger joint there of polygons. Next, let's switch to the multi shift, bring up the numerical. At this stage, just make sure that your inset and shift is on contour and group polys, and then let's pull this out. So I'm pulling out a little bit like so, if you look in my right view. And then what I'm doing is right mouse click to create another shift, pulling it out again, and one more like so. And then what I'm going to do is bring out one to about, let's say there, let's say that, we'll go with that as a bit. Okay, so I've got three little shifts and a large shift like so. So we'll drop the tool and deselect the selection. Now what I'm going to do is select that poly and that poly of this larger section, go to select loop, then we'll go back to multi shift, bring up the numerical. Under shift contours, let's switch it to local points normal, and then let's drag out and let's drag it in a little bit, this hammer bit. What I'm going to do is drag it like this a little bit and in, and then I'm going to right mouse click and do it again, but bring it in a little bit more. So we get something like that, and then we'll drop the selection and deselect. So if you press the tab key on your keyboard, you'll see the shape of the hammer in subpatched and how it's looking. So that's okay currently. Let's we'll stick with that for the time being. So for the back, let's select these two here. Go to multi-shift, numerical, switch it back to contours. Let's pull it out and in a little bit. Let's just, in fact, we'll go do it about that much. Then we'll right mouse and we'll do it again, giving it a bit more. To about, let's say, to about there. Okay, so you've got that little bit coming out. So we're going to make the little claw bits here now. So let's go back to multi-shift again, and let's make some segments coming out that we can then manipulate down. So I'm just gonna pull out a bit and then right mouse click and let's pull out another bit and another bit, so it's getting thinner. In fact, what we'll also do, because remember I need two parts, is where it says group polygons, unclick that so we're getting the two hooks separate. And then right mouse click and let's just do one other bit that's a bit thinner, like so. Like that. So something like this. So I'm just going for some kind of my own kind of stylized hammer. And then what we'll do is we'll just use simply the move and rotate to rotate the points into position for this. So let's drop that section. So let's just subpatch it, see what we've got so far. So we're getting there. So next, let's switch the points, and then I'm going to right mouse click and lasso select these back points, and then what we'll do is we'll use the rotate and move to kind of bend them over a bit. So I'm going to make sure I'm on in my action centers on mouse, and then if we rotate. And obviously it rotates where you click a little bit. Let's deselect these two and that one. And what I'm going to do is go to move. I'm going to move this one back a bit, what I've selected, and then rotate. So I'm using T and Y to jump between them. So move, and then just moving it in. So again, it's up to you how much of a bend you want these to have. And again, so just kind of moving and rotating where you kind of want it to go. Again, they can be as long or short, or it's up to you how far you want these to come. I mean, if you want them to come further, you can come pull them out further down here. So let's select these points. Can move them down, and again just play around, click the tab, let's have a look whereabouts we are with it, so that kind of thing. So let's jump back. So we'll also, let's go down here, we'll select this point here, we'll chamfer it again like the other bit so far, so it's a roughly similar size to this, so we can join those two bits up if you want. Then drop the selection, let's jump to polygons, multi-shift, I can move that down one, maybe two, three, little shift. So let's have a look. So we've got that slot into that bit. Now at this minute in time, I mean, that's kind of looking like the hammer end, but there's not a lot of polys, and I want some of these corners to be tighter rather than just one poly wrapped all the way around. And incidentally, I am using Catnam Clark at the bottom, so make sure you're on Catnam Clark. So while we're on this, let's go to Detail tab, and we're going to go to Edit Edges, and we're going to add some edges. So let's decide what we're going to do. So I'm going to add an edge along here. So what I'm going to come over here, and you'll see this little orange line with a dot on it. Right mouse click, and then you get this new line. And then once this line's on, you can choose to select it and move it up to where you want. So let's say I was going to put it there, and I drop the selection, and you're getting a bit more of a tighter joint. So again, I'm going to right mouse click. Let's move this one up as well. Let's have a look what they look like. So now I've put these two polys, that gives it a flatter look here at the top. Just looks all right. Go back to do something similar to the bottom. So I'm right mouse clicking. Let's pull this down to there. Let's add another one about there. Let's just see what that looks like. So again, getting this flatter look, which is not bad. I mean, it could do making it a bit thinner overall, the whole thing. And again, let's come in here and add a couple of edges like so. So you've got this shape. I mean, we could bring this more forward so it's even flatter at the front. I mean, that's up to you. We can put some on the opposite way as well. So if we put here, let's bring one to there, and let's bring one about there. Let's have a look what that does. So you're making this more of a flatter body. If you want it like that. If you don't, if you want to edit edges, you can delete them. If you hold shift on your keyboard, look, when I go over them. So I'm holding shift, I'm just left mouse clicking, I'm deleting those edges and dropping them. If you don't want them, you decide, and you can do that with any of them. You can start reducing them right down. Again, it's up to you. I mean, obviously, because I'm not actually copying an exact hammer, I'm just kind of making it up based on loads of hammers I've seen. You can then decide on how you want to stylize this as well, which, I mean, if anyone has a go of it and wants to put their own twist on it and that, jump over to the Lightwave Salvation Facebook group and post it. I'll have a look. I'll give you my opinion. So now let's say I wanted to make some of this a bit thinner. I mean, we could just come in and make the whole lot thinner. I'm just going to lasso, let's say, the bottom bit here, like so. So you could literally come in if you wanted to. Use the stretch tool. Let's go on to local, and you could bring it in a bit like this. Now bring in the whole thing in. Let's just drop some of this like so, and again stretch. I mean, I'm making this bit up now, so if it comes, and let's bring it in that way a bit, so you've got that body coming in as well. That's tighter. And again, you could do the same to the top if you want. I think in fact you could even, let's say if I selected these two sets of, not that one, edges, and then you could simply move them about, giving it a kind of unique look if you want, or again the opposite, giving it this kind of ridge. But again, that this is completely up to you. I mean, let's have a go at the, see what happens if we play about with the stretch tool and bring it in and so forth. So again, I'm not going to do much more to that. I mean, I could do, and I might do in my own time, because I would say it's not quite finished. Maybe I would want to bring this the back end, the whole of the back end in a little bit, again with the stretch, maybe bring it in so it's thinner, so you get that, which is quite nice. But let's just place it where we need it to be now. So I'm going to turn both layers on, I'm going to select one poly at the top, and then I'm going to go to selections, and anything connect. Oops, wrong one. I'm going to select one polygon, and then select connected. And then what we need to do is check it's facing the right way, which I kind of built it on that. So now what we need to do is we'll slot it with here, rotate it. I mean, I want to do it on mouse as well. And what we want to do is we just need to make sure it's roughly placed where I want it to be, and obviously facing the right way, like so. And I suppose we could say that there's a stylized hammer done. So I'm going to finish here. Hope you've enjoyed the tutorial. Please share, subscribe, and like I said, check out Lightwave Salvation Facebook group. I've decided I'm going to do, I don't know why, I'm going to decide I'm going to do a series of different tools. I might do a chisel next, and maybe a saw, and just do some tools and stuff, because it's good practice for doing using your modeling skills and getting them up. And I'll try and use a variety of tools as well, so you get to use more tools. Thanks for listening. Look out for my next tutorial.